First, it was Kevin the Cube. Then, it was Sally the Sphere. We need to come up with a name collectively for the helicopter in Fortnite right now. We need all hands on deck, so make sure to go to the comment section and let me know what we should be calling this helicopter. Hey guys, I'm Dr. P, and welcome back today for another video. I really appreciate you taking the time to stop back by. Now, in this one, guys, we have several things to go over involving new storyline developments and happenings, but before we get into it, I want to give a shout out, of course, to the Fruit Faction. Thank you guys so much for using my code in the Fortnite item shop. It really means a lot to me. If you want to get a shout out for yourself like these legends, make sure to send me a screenshot on Twitter showing that you support me. So in my last video, I was talking a little bit about Lux and how she could possibly end up being a dragon and have a transformation at some point this season. If you watched that video, then you know that there is overwhelming evidence to point out that she could in fact be a dragon. One of the biggest hints is right on her. She has a tattoo of a dragon on her shoulder. I want to start this video off by throwing in another piece to that theory and kind of showing something else that I didn't even notice before. So my friend Joseph over on Twitter actually sent me this picture saying, "I don't know if you know this, but the Dire Nunchucks have a dragon that looks like Lux's tattoo." And very clearly, there is a dragon, you know, just like the one on Lux's tattoo, just like the one on this master key loading screen, sitting directly on the nunchucks there, and I'm wondering if there's any connection there. I definitely know it's possible because at one point Epic Games said they had already written the Fortnite storyline, and they already had everything planned from seasons 1 through 9, so they had written all the way up through 9. This was a long time ago, so I'm sure they've even extended that further, but point being, obviously they plan for the future with everything they do in terms of the storyline. Let's take a look at Dire for just a second. Of course, if you don't remember, he's back from the Season 6 Battle Pass. He was actually the Tier 100 skin, which is definitely interesting because Lux is also a Tier 100 skin, and this is the second time now the max skin has had a dragon attached to it, or associated with it in some way. I thought that tweet was really interesting. Thanks, Joseph, for sending that in, and I just wanted to share it with you guys. Alright, so now let's talk about our beloved helicopter. We still gotta find out a name. Don't exactly know what that's gonna be. We're gonna figure it out here in the comment section, so if you haven't already, make sure to go and leave your suggestion. But here you can see it is currently south of Happy Hamlet. It has moved into the snow region, which is really interesting to see. I'm gonna be really curious to see what happens as they get closer to and approach Snobby Shores. There have been some slight variations on the angle at which the telescope is pointed at, but you can see right now it is without a doubt looking directly at Snobby Shores. That's where it's looked generally for the most part. It's been sitting still right here on this little hill by Happy Hamlet for over a day now. I expect it to get closer to Frosty Flights on the next time that it moves. We've been discussing what this helicopter's doing here, why it's here. It's almost certainly setting us up for some big event, ultimately. Why else would it be here? Why else would it be moving almost every day and causing this much stir up? Yes, it's obviously involved with some kind of event coming later this season. Now, there's something interesting I found on Reddit. Of course, I want to show it to you. This comes to us courtesy of user Timo Van Vink, but he says, on the Coaxialcopter glider, there is a number printed on the side. That number is 89. Now, the 89th day of the year is on March 30th. Which, at the time of me recording this video, is only 1 week away. This theory implies that on that day, we could be getting the helicopter event or, you know, something happening involving that helicopter. And, you know, it kind of makes sense. March 30th would end up being on a Saturday, which, of course, is the best time to do an event. But not only that, it's when literally every event has ever happened, for the most part. There might be a few exceptions, but almost every time it's on a Saturday around midday. That is definitely not confirmed, and I can see how that might be kind of a stretch, but I also wouldn't put that by Epic Games. I think that it is possible, and it's just something to bear in mind. Personally, I think whatever event is going to happen is going to happen somewhere around weeks 7 through 9, which is roughly the same time period that we're going to be able to finally unlock the Discovery skin and learn their true identity. Reddit is truly a great place. Speaking of Reddit, I've got another graphic to show you. this time by user iClapsI, and this one is really cool. It says the helicopter is looking at all of the old crater locations from season 4 to see if they forgot any hop rocks. So far, through the first couple stops that it's made, it does look like it's kind of following that same trend. You can see, of course, the red circles were the sites of the previous crater. Impact zones, of course, left when the comet hit the map originally back in late season 3, early season 4. In case you missed it, when the helicopter first got into the game like 2 weeks ago or something like that, it was data mined that the hop rocks would be coming back in some way, at least in the prop folder of the game. New hop rock files were added. So, I mean, is it possible that we could see hop rocks actually come back? The helicopter is the same one from the middle of Dusty Divot and from Moisty Mire, from way back when. We know for a fact that the helicopter that was in the middle of the divot belonged to the government. They were there extracting something out of the middle of that asteroid, which of course turned out to be the visitor. It seems like everything comes back to the visitor. But anyway, bottom line is we know the helicopter did at one time belong to the government, just for lack of a better word, and now it's shown up here again. And the telescopes are looking basically at every one of these crater impact sites. Considering the leak we got showing explicitly hop rocks are in the game's coding, not only that, but new files were added regarding the hop rocks, I feel like this could be an accurate theory. Here's something I just thought of. Remember back a couple seasons ago when we got this glider that had this on it that said literally, "Warning, nuclear missile launched." Everyone's got to remember that because it was wild. I was making so many videos talking about it. Well, everyone was really, because it looked like something was going to happen. It really looked like the end was coming at some point for something. Sure enough, nothing's happened yet, but that doesn't mean it won't. Now, with that in mind, look at this. This is a real spray in the battle pass that you unlock. I'm not sure what level, but it literally says the end is nigh. What if the helicopter is here scouting out the area because they're gonna drop some kind of a nuclear missile on us or something like that? And maybe that's how they could transition into a new map, or at the very least, a heavily transformed map. It would be almost like a wasteland. I would love to hear your thoughts, your opinions, your ideas. I value them a lot more than you know, so without a doubt, make sure to leave your comments. This game right here was insane, man. I've already got 7 kills. We're getting down to the end. It's a wild finish. You guys are definitely going to want to stick around and watch. I can't lose this one. Play safe. Don't stay out in the open where they can land and shoot you.
I don't know where they are.
Where get that care package. No, it's out the zone. Oh, okay.
No. I am fully looted. I don't need to risk it.
Yeah. Good call.
I'm just going to build up right here, to be honest. Run the zone.
Yep. All right. I wish we could get rid of some of these trees.
Deforestation is nice.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Oh, you see him in the ball? Oh, there's some guy down here.
I see him. Oh, he ran. He went back inside. Mr. Ball. I'm going to try to get rid of his ball and just put damage into it. I'm hitting it. It's got to be relatively weak.
Oh, behind us. Oh, I just took a lot of damage.
He's on me. I'm on him. Got him.
You got him?
Oh, they got ballers over there. They're on the tree. Two of them are in ballers.
That's two.
Yep.
So there's one by himself and then two being plebeians.
I'm going for the ballers, dude. Let's just get them. They're not going to get out.
Hang on. I'm going for the care package. I gotta see. Oh, he's right here. There's a guy right here going for the care package.
Coming. That's the last guy. Oh, okay, the last two were in ballers.
He's out in the storm. Yeah, he just died in the storm.
Yep, get ready, dude. Here they are. They're in their ballers.
One jumped out.
Yep, and his friend's going to his friend's not jumping out.
I got one. Whoa, he's up there. He's up there. You got to get him. I believe in you. It's the last guy. You killed so many earlier. I believe in you.
Oh, he's just... That's annoying. Yes!
Nice!
Oh!
We have 15 kills that game.